Well, I don't.
Pew, 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 pew.
I lied. Neither do I.
Pew, 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 pew.
Hi, I'm Jeff Becker, creator of Alterkind. Here to talk to you about my new book, Planetary Survey. Inside Planetary Survey, you'll find all sorts of... Dude. Blank pages. That sucks. I guess that's why I need your help. So, I'm here to talk to you about it. If you scroll down a little bit, you'll see a little flip book there, a little bit further. Yeah. No, over, yeah, right there. So, inside that is what I kind of hope it looks like when it's all done. To help me out, I'm here to beg for your money. Got all sorts of great pledge levels, starting with this cool little sticker here for just a couple bucks. Further levels include these sweet little pins with all sorts of the new races. Got the Paracor, the Oldham, and the Etikin. Different levels include some of the books in different formats, including, of course, Planetary Survey, because that's what this is for. Other ones include the Player's Handbook, which inside you'll find all sorts of stuff like prestige classes, mutations, cybernetics. Further, you can go ahead and pledge and get Dossier. It's my second book. It's in beautiful color. Check that out. It's full of more class options, you can customize everything, all that. And then you can also go ahead and get The Ones We Were. It's a module for it. Got all sorts of cool little mutants in there. Aliens crash, there's a crazy cult leader. Also, if you go ahead, you can get this awesome GM screen designed by Stephen McAndrews. He's a pretty sweet dude. On the back is all the helpful information so you don't get lost. That's my stuff. I hope you check it out. Share with your friends, anyone that might be interested in, you know, role-playing. Use a D20 Pathfinder kind of system. Great. And thank you for checking me out. I look forward and I'm hopeful that you help me out. Later. Oh, hey. I forgot to tell you about some of the reviews that I've got. Denver Comic Con calls me a favorite. There was a guy there that said, hey, this looks pretty cool. I think I'll tell my friend about it. My mom, she says, that's nice, dear. And she also thinks I'm very handsome. So, thanks for checking me out. I really appreciate it. Go ahead and tell your friends about it. And thanks again.
Scott Gable here at Zombie Sky Press. You ever wish you had more Pathfinder role-playing game options for the Fae? More delightfully weird options? As a longtime lover of the Fae, I've been hunting far and wide for more ways to incorporate them into my gaming life. And the answer, my friends, is the Fairy Ring. This is the book that gets into the nitty-gritty, into the down and dirty of all things Fae. It spills all their darkest secrets and pulls out your inner trickster. This is the book the Fae do not want you to read. But we've got you back, friends. We think you need to know, and soon. We're so close to finishing this first step, and the design and the illustrations are blowing us away. The book has 10 chapters focused on powerful Fae Lords. Maybe they're the bad guys in a campaign, maybe they're the patrons of the party, maybe they're both. Each chapter provides extensive details on a specific Fae Lord and their servitors. Each chapter has a new Fae player race, new Fae monsters, cities, planes, and more. I can't wait for you to see what we have planned, and I hope you'll support Zombie Sky Press in bringing you more Fae.
Hello, everybody. I wanted to take a moment to make a video discussing the upcoming new Dungeons & Dragons movie. We had a post about this on our Facebook group, Old School Roleplaying, and there were a lot of good suggestions. A couple of things that were mentioned that I thought were good suggestions. Guillermo del Toro, I believe that's how you pronounce his name, and Peter Jackson were both suggested as directors. I think either one of those guys would do a pretty good job, considering how successful Peter Jackson was with the Lord of the Rings films, which I thought he did absolutely fantastic with the Lord of the Rings films, and not as much with the Hobbit films, although Toro hasn't necessarily hit it out of the park every time either. I don't know any director that has. But I think going with not going so high fantasy or high magic fantasy, going with lower magic or less magic in the film probably would be a wise suggestion. I think that planning the film in a trilogy is a good idea as well. And we also, there was a comment somebody made about not having the film be named Dungeons & Dragons, because the first Dungeons & Dragons film did so horribly. And I think a large part of the reason for that is because it wasn't really taken seriously. It was more of a comedy, in my opinion, and I really didn't like the comedy aspect. I think a Dungeons & Dragons film needs to have a very more serious feel to it. Like the Fellowship of the Ring, I think, had a really balanced feel to the film. And there was a real sense of danger and urgency. The characters, for the most part, were believable, I believe. That's something that I think that the Dungeons & Dragons movie is going to need, is going to need some believability. I think that not placing too many iconic monsters from Dungeons & Dragons in the film, or not worrying about that so much, and focusing more on the story and really have some good quality writing. Getting, like for instance, possibly having Ernest Gygax Jr. Be a consultant on the film, I think would be a good idea. Or Luke Gygax, or both. Just because. I was thinking about the, those guys would do great. I think they would give very good suggestions and lead Hasbro or Universal Studios or whoever it is that would be financing this film or producing it. I was also thinking some about the classes and races that I would like to see in the film. Of course, humans, I think, should be the dominant race in the world, whatever setting they use, whether it's Greyhawk or Kryn or Mystara or Forgotten Realms. I would like to see Greyhawk, but I know that they're really promoting Forgotten Realms with Dungeons & Dragons 5th Edition, so I would say they would most likely probably go with the Forgotten Realms setting. As far as races are concerned, I think going with... I know that they're going to make the film probably based around Dungeons & Dragons 5th Edition as the Book of Vile Darkness, the Dungeons & Dragons movie Book of Vile Darkness, which I think had the potential to be a really good film. I think of the three Dungeons & Dragons movies, it was the best one of the three. And I don't even know who produced that one or what the budget was. It wasn't great, but it wasn't absolutely horrible either. I think they should probably try to stay away from, have more anti-hero kind of aspects to the film, because When it gets to be too much good guy, and too much bad guy, it becomes a little ridiculous. I think that having a bad guy that doesn't really see themselves as a bad guy, or a group of bad guys, and the good guys, you know, have flaws, and not a bunch of lawful good paladins. But races, I would like to see, you know, halflings portrayed more in a Lord of the Rings sense. Not that I didn't like the Kenders in Dragonlance, but when I think of Dungeons & Dragons, I think of, you know, kind of a more of a Middle Earth feel. I think an orc should be a dominant, and I say that, but maybe not so much. I mean, we saw that orcs and Uruk-hai were kind of a dominant force in Middle Earth, but it'd be great to see ogres and trolls and have, you know, the evil races kind of working together in sort of the Warhammer world sense. And I don't know that the movie necessarily has to be so epic. If it's a good story of an adventuring party, this was a comment that was made in the group as well, you know, a story about an adventuring party, and it'd be great to see a gnome, maybe a gnome illusionist. It's just something that's kind of been lost, I think. You know, the elven wizard that has a spell book, or, you know, I guess it doesn't have to be an elven wizard, but maybe multi-class characters, and, you know, an elven ranger perhaps would be. But then again, we're getting closer to the Lord of the Rings film, and not that it couldn't be somewhat parallel to the Lord of the Rings in a lot of ways. I mean, there was a fellowship, a party that went on an adventure. In the Fellowship of the Ring, they, you know, we're talking about a Dungeons & Dragons movie here. They went into a dungeon, more or less, and fought a Balrog, which was very iconic, and I think pretty fantastic. One of the things from the film that I remember that really stuck out to me was when Gandalf mentioned that he was a servant of the Secret Fire, and how that really stood out in my mind, you know, thinking about that just the depth and the inner workings of the world needs to be there. The layers need to exist. You know, I don't think that the film necessarily has to be based off of a successful series of fantasy Dungeons & Dragons books. I believe that a lot of people would like to see The Underdark or Undermountain. I would love to see, you know, a dragon or a pair of dragons mated, or, you know, possibly sibling dragons or something like that. It would be also awesome. Somebody had mentioned that, you know, in a trilogy, have them start out on maybe like Keep of the Borderlands and go through the Temple of Elemental Evil. And I thought that was a pretty cool idea. I would throw in Against the Giants in there. Although I was thinking the other day, you know, like Jack the Giant Slayer, I don't know if that was that great of a film. But I think, you know, the way that Gary wrote, and, you know, that was one of the most successful beginning modules for Dungeons & Dragons, was Against the Giants. Yeah. I think that was the first serious applied module series for Advanced Dungeons & Dragons. I'm pretty sure. I don't know now. Well, I mean, post maybe Blackmoor, perhaps. At any rate, I think the Dungeons & Dragons film has a lot of potential. There's a lot of good ideas out there. I love the idea of maybe letting the bad guys win, or when the party gets through the Temple of Elemental Evil, possibly in the first movie, the party dies, and the second movie follows up with another party that does, you know, return to the Temple of Elemental Evil or something of that nature. So, the Dungeons & Dragons movie is something that I look forward to. Certainly, I think they should name it something unique that doesn't necessarily have to reflect Dungeons & Dragons. I think they should have Dungeons and Dragons in the movie. And a Freet would be something really cool to have in the film as well. So those are just some meandering thoughts that I had. And so please share your thoughts, and if you enjoyed the video, please like, share, and subscribe. Thanks, guys.